Do you want to make over $100,000? That is life-changing money, huh? Contact CJ Noel at 239-404-9649 to obtain your insurance license. Mention No Cupcake Zone.
You are now listening to the No Cupcake Zone podcast, sponsored by CJ Noel Insurance Services, where you can find all your financial and insurance solutions. For more information, please contact cjnoelinsurance.com or call 239-403-8391. Make sure to also visit nocupcakezone.com for future and past shows. Enjoy the show.
RTP. I'm a sure nigga, how nigga, nigga do a fuck nigga. One track. Never sit in a motherfucking building. Young Gotti. Nigga, you so nameless. When you're dressed in the best and them hoes be on your trail. Like, nigga, suit you for cool in here. Been raised by nothing but head. Nigga, so nameless. When them young niggas, dumb niggas, fuck a one-on-one nigga. Make it one nigga, grab a gun nigga. Hands ain't one nigga, ain't none nigga to a young nigga. Bitch, I'm from Naples.
We can tell by the way a nigga hustle. We humble, let's jungle where we come from. River Park to the trail.
You already know what it is. Enough said. You know where I'm from.
Born a boy, but I'm going to the nurses. A little bit of baby grew up by that. Learn my swag, I swear from swag. Told that fire, and I will use that. Listen, nigga, rapping up a blues juice kid. Smoking Nick when I'm loaded in the back of my shit. Holding up and see the niggas talk like this. Knowing them shit while I walk like this. Skunk.
From a grandma high to the G to see what you know about me. I'm a bank.
Man, I'm kind of hungry. I'm about to go to... Oh, it's closed, but you know what? I'm about to close down shop. You already know what it is. Your boy Triple Black is back on the scene.
Putting clean candy paints on their car. Who had the rawest lack thus far? Could it be Kermit or could it be Pop?
It's your boy Triple Black, a.k.a. the number one stunner, a.k.a. the boss, a.k.a. Gordon River, Ron Trey, and Jasmine K. Oh, Black bitch, you already know what it is, man. No Cupcake Zone podcast, man. I'm back, bitch. Anyways, man, I got the boy, Young Gotti. He's not in the building, but he's in the building. Hey, man, quick commercial break, and I'm going to be back. No Cupcake Zone. Podcast. Hey, make sure you guys go to iTunes, Spreaker, and nocupcakezone.com. It's very important, man. I need to get my subscriber shit up, man. Y'all need to support your boy, man. Stop pump faking, bro. I need this, man. Just go and hit the subscribe button. Hey, shout out to CJ Noel Insurance Services, man. Life insurance, car insurance, health insurance, everything, man. Y'all need to check him out, man. Quick commercial break, man.
Have you ever asked yourself, what if something happens to me? How is my family protected? Will I be able to retire one day? Am I covered? Are my taxes filed correctly? These are all important questions that need to be answered. Visit the experts at CJ Noel Insurance Services for all your financial and insurance needs. Internationally known for their excellence, CJ Noel Insurance has proudly served the Naples area for over 20 years and is the number one Blue Cross Blue Shield health insurance provider in the Southwest Florida area. Conveniently located in Naples at 2800 Davis Boulevard, Suite 208. Stop by or call 239-403-8391 for an appointment or a quote.
With over 20,000 plays in over 20 different countries, you are now listening to the hottest show in Southwest Florida, hosted by the best host in Southwest Florida, the number one stunner, Triple B-L-A-C-K.
You are now listening to the No Cupcake Zone podcast, where there ain't nothing sweet, hosted by your boy, Triple Black. Now back to our show.
Man, we back in the building. We got Young Gotti in not the building, but he's in the building. Let me give you a round of applause, bro.
Well, boy.
Nothing, man. What's good with you, bro? Mr. Bipolar on safety. What's good?
Just working, dog. Trying to get this music up, you know?
I feel you, man. Damn, bro. Hey, man. When I knew you, you were Pee-wee, man. Somewhere you got a family member that's really disappointed right now because they can't call you Uncle Pee-wee. You know what I'm talking about? You on Switch to Gotti. How did that happen, bro?
I don't know. I guess it just fit. You know what I'm saying?
I feel you, man. But, dog, I miss old hood nicknames. Because any place you go, there's a Pee-wee. Like, my girl got an Uncle Pee-wee, man. You know? Like, yeah. Old nicknames like fat this, you know, or black this, or, you know, every hood got a peanut or a booby or a kiki. Do we even have hood nicknames anymore? Because everybody's a rapper. You know, everybody's got a rap name now. Do we still have like fat and black and big this and big that?
I mean, everybody's still going by their same name, you know?
Yeah.
It's just, you know, a younger generation.
Yeah. No Leroys, you know what I'm saying? No Leons or something like that, you know? Hood names, dog. I miss those, dog. Everybody's like Chopper City this and Chopper that, Young Chop. Man, what happened to just the old, good, black nicknames, man? I miss them, bro.
We went on the internet then.
You know? I guess. That's what it is, dog. You know what I'm saying? Every female, there's no Kikis anymore. It's like Miss Bootylicious, Thotlicious, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Pee-wee, man. Damn. I slipped up, bro.
Hey, they still call me Pee-wee.
They still call you Pee-wee?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Good, man. That's for the same, man. I know one of your nephews or your nieces would be like, man, I want to call him Pee-wee, not Young Gotti. I don't feel like calling him a rapper. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. They call me Pee-wee, though. They call me Gotti when they're trying to be funny.
Oh, real?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. My bad, dog. I wasn't trying to be funny. I thought you was Young Gotti, bro. But
no, not like that. Just them. That's how they be.
Yeah. Hey, talk about growing up in Naples, man.
That was everything when I was young.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you know, I'm originally from Fort Myers.
Oh, real? You were born in Fort Myers?
I'm born in Fort Myers. Yeah.
Okay. I'm here right now, man. Hey, give me a couple allies. I'm scared to go out the door, man. You know, can I reference your name? You know what I'm saying? Just in case I step on somebody's shoe or something.
You straight out there, man. Yes.
I just fucking with you, man. Hey, no, I remember you used to be right across the way all the time, you know, Scent. I love Scent, man. I miss her, man. My mom loves Scent too, man. You guys, y'all had a gang of people, man. Yeah? Tell her I said what's up, man.
Come on,
Yeah, man. You guys had a gang of family. Like, damn, boy. You couldn't, it wasn't just one of y'all. That was like, man, I felt sorry for like your parents and stuff like that, because y'all had like a good 20 little kids all around the same age, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's still like that, though. You know, it's still family.
Yeah, man. You guys stuck together big time, man. Everybody, boy. Shod, Piggy, man. You guys rolled deep. Yeah, man. Dog, talk about growing up on One Tray. One Tray used to be where all the pretty people used to hang out at. You know what I'm saying? All the... you know, the savages used to be out on the corner over there on Gordon River. You know, everybody used to, all the pretty thugs and stuff like that used to be on your street, dog. Talk about it, man. I know it's changed a little bit.
Yeah, it wasn't no pretty thugs. We just were, you know what I'm saying? We all grew up together.
Yeah.
And just didn't take no, you feel me? We didn't take no shit. You feel me? Yeah. You got to protect, you know what I mean, your hood. You got to protect your hood.
No, I got you, man.
Ain't nobody else gonna do that. Yeah. And then when you fuck with your hood so much, you know what I mean? They're gonna show you love.
Mm-hmm.
And they're gonna protect you.
Man, I remember, because I'm a little bit older than you guys, and I came back from college. My nephew, Booze, I think he's around you guys' age, or might be a little bit younger, man. I remember he was like, don't go on 13th Street. I was like, what? Don't go on 13th Street. He's like, One Tray. They got a gang there. I was like, for real? Yeah, man. You guys really were jumping.
It ain't no gang, man. It ain't no gang.
Well, y'all really.
That's what street.
Huh?
That's what street we came from. You feel me? So we just call it, we just call ourselves 13th Street, boy. It wasn't no gang shit, nothing like that. And we just didn't play. You feel me? It's like, say if you going to war with somebody, right?
Yeah.
And you don't want to keep fighting them. You know what I mean? Continue to fight them, all that junk there. You just want to end it off rip.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's just how we approached things. We just didn't play.
You guys was fighting all the time.
But we was cool as shit, though.
Yeah. No, man, it just took me by surprise. You know, when I was growing up, you know, the only... you know, prominent thing that used to happen was like parties at the big house. You know, nobody, it was just a lot of old people. Nobody used to be out the big house would be the only place where anything was. And he was just telling me, oh, man, you know, the boys live down there, man. It was a little bit different. But talk about some, you know, you had a large family. I mean, talk about some mentors growing up, man. You know, people that gave you the game.
I learned from basically everybody. You know what I mean? Like J-Buck, Ram, Shabu, 50, Long, Pimp, Tiki. Man, I can go on for days, bro.
Yeah.
Like people who influenced me. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But what I was asking, we'll get... you know, laser sharp on this. Who was the person that when you were growing up, you know what I'm saying? I'm not asking you to dick ride or anything like that. Who was a guy that like, man, you know what? That's the dude I want to be right there.
My big brother, Shod.
Shod? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out to Shod, man. Like
the person I wanted to be.
Rouse. Ross always had some girls with him, dog. Always around some women, dog. That's one thing. He was like the plug for girls, bro. He had every phone number, dog. Seriously, dog. I'm not even lying. Dog. If you want to find some info about some girl or get their number or something like that, Shy was the guy. Yeah. Hey, man, what's going on over there, man? I know Uncle Pimp, I'm famous, man. I haven't seen him on Facebook in a little while. was talking about the community, things were going on over there, man. I know you, your family stays involved with that type of stuff, man. What's going on, man, with the gas station and all that stuff?
Like, bro, to tell you the truth, I haven't been, like, following it, to be honest with you. I just been working on my music, you know what I mean?
Oh, okay. Yeah, because I know there was some big to-do down there, you know, where they were trying to build a gas station on a corner where yeah. that empty field's at. And, you know, they put cameras down on the street monitoring people, yeah. you know, a whole bunch of fuck shit. Yeah.
But see, like, yeah, I feel them on that. But, like, the protesting and all that, they can do. I'm, like, not the person for it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Just my image that the police have.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't want to be in their face. I don't want to be taunting them. You know what I mean? Because they can do stuff for you. You feel me?
Oh, absolutely. You ain't got to tell me. I know. I know, man. So have you had some encounters that you were, I guess, profiled down there?
Every time I encounter them.
Yeah.
Because it's like gang. Once you label as a gang member, that's going to follow you for the longest. And they're going to always mess with you. Regardless of where they see you at, you could be doing good. If you get pulled over in the car automatically gets searched, you know?
So they really harass you guys about that? I mean, my bad, man. It sounded like I was dry snitching or something like that, saying one tray. But that's still, they still fuck with you guys about that?
Yeah, that ain't gonna never go nowhere.
Real talk.
They always gonna do that, even while you doing good. You know, you can stay at their face. As long as you don't mess with them, you straight, stay at their face. But if your name get brought up or something, that's the first thing that they gonna see that's gonna pop up.
Oh, okay. All right. Damn, that was a long time ago. They still really, like, bring up old shit like that. Yeah.
Always, bro.
That's fucked up, man.
That's why we just, you know, do positive stuff. Stay low.
Yeah, man. Hey, Uncle Pimp, man, me and him had a conversation. And one thing that I thought was really interesting, and I thought that was actually, I want to commend you on that, is acknowledging bipolar disorder.
Yeah.
Were you was there something that happened in your life? I mean, you can be as candid as you want to, or if you don't want to be candid, that made you, where you got diagnosed as bipolar disorder.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bipolar disorder phase 2, you know, but I ain't noticed it until like I had got grown. When I was a kid, I was just so bad, you know, in and out of programs and shit like that, fighting and just fucking up shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then one time I just pushed it too far. And so I got checked and they diagnosed me with that shit.
Oh, okay. Man, you know what? That is kind of brave of you, because especially within our community, when, you know, mental disorders sounds like such a negative word or negative conversation. But yeah. There's so many things that we are scared to talk about that within our community that we need to have a dialogue about because of the stigma. For example, I just had a child, right? And postpartum depression. Huh?
I said congratulations, too.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, man. Thank you. But what I was saying is postpartum depression is it's a real thing. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of women go through it. But because of the negative stigma that gets attached to it, a lot of people don't like to talk about it. They don't like to recognize it. And they don't like to, you know, manage it. And I'm commending you that you are upfront and say, you know what? I got this issue and I'm dealing with it, man. But how were you like that right out the gate, or did it, you know, take, you know, some coercing to really acknowledge and deal with this?
It was easy for me because I ain't never changed. I always liked being bipolar. You know what I mean? It's like I never changed. I always be myself. But I understand, like, it's different levels of bipolar. You know what I mean? Yeah. You have, like, depression. You have that angry stage. Then you have that numb stage. There's so many, like, different stages of it that can happen in a little bit of time. It's like you ain't got no choice but to embrace it. You know what I mean?
Right.
And so once you started, like, noticing it and you got a name to put to it, it kind of get a little bit easier, but still it don't change nothing.
Right.
Unless you're taking, like, medications and all that shit.
I know. Can you explain? Because a lot of people misdiagnose themselves. You know, a lot of people, like, are manic depressive, or, you know, they have real highs and real lows. What's the difference between being a manic depressive and a bipolar person?
A bipolar person is like everything.
Okay.
Like,
so you have highs, lows, everything.
Yeah, everything. But it's so quick. It can happen all in like 5 minutes.
Right.
You know what I mean? But it's all, every feeling, just all into one. Every type of whatever they call them, mental disorders, all that, that people snap and all that. It's just all that shit in one.
Okay. Now, do you think that actually when you are having, I guess, a certain episode, does that help you in your music, in your creativity?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Because every time that I do a song, I'm not going to feel a certain, like, type of way about that song. You know what I mean? Every beat that I hear is not going to be the same as the last beat I heard. You know what I mean? So I get to put my feelings into whatever that beat tells me to do. And then I can explain it from so many different ways that it's like, you can do it all. R&B, rap, all that shit.
Right. Is there a certain part, I guess, of you or of this that you want to chant, that's the best? You know, like, you know, some people, they work best when they're like hype and angry and just, you know, just irritated. Is there a part of your personality that works best in music that you like, that you think sounds the best?
All of it.
All of it? Okay.
You know what I mean? I feel like everything I make is the best. Because if I don't like it, it won't go nowhere. I'll stop.
I got you, man. Hey, Set for Life. Set for Life, man. Was that your click?
That was the label that we had started.
Yeah.
You know, me and my brother, Risha Man, my homeboy Tank. You know, that was the label we had started at first that we was using. And then we just kind of like just let it go.
Yeah. So who's your affiliation with now?
I'm with Team Really Real.
Team Really Real. That's Shabu. Yeah. Shabu, man.
Yeah.
Man, talk about that movement, man. Are you guys still doing, you know, Jump Out Boys and all that stuff?
Yeah, you know, that's still the click. But we just have something that we focused on, you know, right now.
Yeah. Talk about it, man. Why we really want to understand what Really Real is. Is it a record label or is it like a spiritual movement?
It's like both.
Both.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because you can do a lot, though, through music. You can influence a lot through music. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
So if you speaking real shit through your music, you getting attention from, you know what I mean, real shit.
Yeah.
It's just like being not judgmental, you know what I mean?
Yeah. You've had a little bit of success in rapping and stuff like that. I'm going to bust a couple shots. Let me bust a couple shots. Hey, you've had a little bit of success, right? You know, there's a lot of competition in Naples area, Fort Myers or whatever. Has anybody dropped salt on you?
Never.
Never. Okay.
Yeah, I never had like a beef with nobody.
No? But do you feel like you get the support that you need or should get within the city?
I mean, yeah, I do. I get all the support. You know what I mean?
This is no cupcake zone, man. Bust up shop. I'm going to ask you a question. Is there any people that you would like to put on full blast? I've seen some of your Facebook posts, and it sounds like you got at some people. So let's talk about it, bro. This is no cupcake zone.
I ain't got no beef with nobody. I just say however I be feeling. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm not talking about beef. I'm just talking about you know, anybody dropping salt on you or, you know, not supporting you where they should be supporting you.
Nah, because I support whoever supports me.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So if they don't support me, I'm not supporting them. So everybody who I support is like my team. That's the only people I'm worried about.
Okay. All right. Man, I just tried to cause a little controversy, man.
It ain't no controversy with me. Anybody can tell you that.
Yeah, I got
you. Know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, you up front with everybody. So, it's whatever had to been said is already been said. So, I got you. Who are you working with, dog? Talk about the team.
Right now?
Yeah.
Shit. It's just me and bro. You know, Shabu. Blockstar Promotions. Prestigious Promotion. Moneybag. That's like the team. That's what we working on, something big. You feel me? I can't say it, but we working on something big. You feel me? That we got going on, man. But that's like my team.
So the part of the team, man, are you? Who's like the boss? You know what I'm talking about? I know you guys are all bosses in your own right, but who is like the quarterback, if you say?
Everybody, man. We don't have no bosses. We don't look up to nobody being better. You feel me?
No, I'm not saying that.
We all work with each other, man. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no boss. We ain't got no boss. You feel me? God, that's the boss.
Man, talk about bipolar on safety project, dog. And,
it's bipolar off safety.
Oh, off safety. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Talk about that project, bro.
Man, I've been working on this CD for like so long, dog. This mixtape for so long, bro. And I haven't like put it out because either something happened or I feel like I done elevated from that music. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I ain't put it out yet. But bipolar off safety is like everything. It's going to be like so much different feelings from every point of view. You know what I'm saying? Like shit that dudes won't say, I'm going to say it.
Yeah. It's funny. No, I was going to say, it's funny that you say that you have all these different feelings and stuff like that. But how is it hard to come up with what makes the CD or the mixtape? Like, for instance, if you're feeling one way when you're in the studio doing that track, and then, you know, final editing and stuff like that, and you hear it, and you feel in a completely different way. How do you deal with that?
I just do something else.
Well,
but I can lock in. I can lock into it. If I'm hearing something, whatever I hear, I can lock into it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I can get back in that same mode that I was in when I was rapping it.
Okay. So do you kind of almost have to lock in like a whole studio session and then knock it all out at one time?
That's how I like to do it, you know?
Yeah.
I have to get at least over 4 hours.
Dash Studios, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you fuck with Will?
Yeah, I fuck with Will.
Yeah, man. So, production-wise, man, who else is on, what other features and other people you got on the, either producing or rapping on your project?
I got Jay Gutter, you know what I mean? I got, Shabu, Major, and really that's about it.
That's it.
I wasn't really even focused on, like, features, like, for it. Because it was originally supposed to be 2 discs.
Okay.
You know? But.
Yeah. What's your signature track? The track, like, you know, if Puff Daddy came and he flew to Naples. I mean, I wouldn't say that you signed with Bad Boy or, you know, whatever. But we're just using Puff Daddy. And you were looking for a deal. What's the track? And talk about the track that you would play for him first.
It had to be What About Us. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, what's the concept of the song?
It's just like What About Us. Like 239, it's a lot of parts of 239. You got Fort Myers, you got Naples. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And Fort Myers get recognized on the music tip, you feel me? But What About Us? You feel me? We 239 too. And they forgot about us over here. So I had to remind them that they forgot about us.
Okay. All right. Are you pulling any cards on anybody on that track?
No, I just told them how I felt. If they don't like it, fuck them.
Hey, man, I was trying to poke you a little bit, trying to get you to go off. Man, Bipolar Off Safety, man. So it's out there. Where can people find it?
I ain't dropped it yet, though, because I'm having, like, some issues with the mastering. But soon as that get done, man, I'm going to give it to him ASAP.
Yeah. I saw you did a video.
But I do got a couple songs on Reverb.
Yeah, Reverb. Saw that you did a video.
Yeah. I ain't worried.
Yeah, I also see that you did a couple features, maybe just one, with that one honky dude. Forgot his name. Florida Honky,
Florida. I think
his name. Yeah.
Yeah, Florida.
Yeah. Do you got anybody else that you working with out there like that do that ask you for a feature?
New people, man. You know? Chopper Jr., I supposed to Ben did a song with, bro. You know,
yeah.
Frank Lennon, we supposed to Ben did a song. That's a lot on Trevor.
Yeah. So who is the person, the biggest person that's reached out to you that fuck with your music that you were very surprised about?
I don't know.
Nobody.
The old people fuck with my music. You know what I mean? Like older people, like 50 and all that shit. They listen to it.
Oh, really?
That shit's surprising.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah, man. Have you ever? Well, like your sound is very unique, and that's what I like about a lot of Naples stuff, especially that song Naples. I don't know. I like that track. What with Neil on there? What happened to that guy? What's his rap name, anyways? Neil.
Oh, Vision?
Is it Vision? Neil. I just knew him at Vision. Neil. Pawn Son. Yeah.
Yeah, that's Vision.
Yeah. Man, how is it, I mean, is it hard not to get sucked in and sounding like everybody else? You know, because everybody else sounds like either the Migos or Future or you know, that churn up stuff. And when I hear music from you or anybody from Naples, it has like that signature sound. Have you ever thought about you know, riding that wave. You know what I'm saying? Because it seems pretty easy to do. You get a good trap beat, some good ad libs, you know, a couple little tight verses, and you're in there.
But that's bullshit, though. I ain't grew up on that type of rap. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And plus, anyway, I'm going to keep my own style. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You got to be unique. You feel me? You can't try to sound like somebody else because it's like you limiting yourself. You want to be just like that person, however far that person got. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I got you. Yeah. Hey, I'm going to put you on the spot. I'm going to ask you two top fives. The first one is going to be your personal top five. The second top five is 239 top five rappers or musicians, whoever, minus yourself. The first one, who's your personal five top rappers of all time? It doesn't, you can just list five of them. It doesn't have to be from top to bottom.
I'm going to say Pop, Wayne, Drake. Let me quit lying. Wayne and Pop.
That's it?
Hey, got the top five. Yeah, that's what I like.
Wayne and Pop. I was the little Boosie or anybody like that?
Oh, yeah, definitely Boosie too, yeah. I can throw him up, though.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah.
So three out of the five. That's it. You didn't acknowledge anybody else. How about 239?
239?
Minus yourself. Who are you fucking with?
Shabu, Solo, Reese. Wizzle. And Tiro.
Damn, boy. Tiro was the last one, but I thought you were gonna keep it home team for everybody, but I fuck with all those dudes too, you know. All right, man. Let me ask you, man. What's the biggest misconception about you that people might think? I know you probably don't give a fuck, but what is a perception that you think that, you know, the public might have about you, and that's just totally not true?
I don't know.
No? All right. Go ahead.
I'm just gangsta ass type of dude. I ain't that type of dude, you feel me? I'm just cool ass person.
So you think people might think that you're this hothead, gangster ass dude that's ready to pop off?
Growing up, I was. When I was a jit.
Yeah.
Shit, I ain't care about nothing. You feel me? But, you know, you don't stay the same person. You got to man up.
Well, absolutely. There's a maturation process and everything, you know? But that is the misconception, the biggest misconception, you think?
Yeah, I guess. Because if it is, I don't hear about it. They ain't going to tell me.
Yeah. Hey, when I was talking to Pimp, man, he said that, Pimp, you know, opened up a little bit. He said that, you know, you suffered, you know, some losses and, you know, some pain, you know, growing up, like your parents and a couple of your homeboys and stuff like that. Talk about that.
Yeah. I mean, shit that everybody go through, you know? You feel me? I try not to think about it.
Yeah. Well, without digging too deep, do you think that it kind of made you the, I mean, of course it made you the person that you are, like feelings wise, because you're so, you've lost so many people. Do you have, I mean, like, feelings, really?
Not really.
Okay.
But I don't think about it. Yeah. You feel me?
Yeah. Two of your closest homeboys, one of them, Lonnie's little brother, died. Which kind of was mysterious, you know, but I'm not here to, you know, make speculations and stuff like that. And plus, you were pretty close to the guy, was it Rashid? You guys still keep in contact a lot?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah?
Always. That's my little brother. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You always got to keep it a hunt.
Yeah. Have they shed any more light on what happened to Lonnie's brother?
Shit, to me, it's like they just done forgot about it.
Yeah? Was there any question of any foul play or any unscrupulous activity?
All you gotta do is just read the Naples Daily News little article on it. If you can't, just like, get the picture from that article alone, it's like, you have to be dumb.
It definitely raised suspicion, because when I read it, maybe I missed they didn't say too much. It was kind of like, yeah, but, you know, they didn't say too much. They were being evasive or something like that. So I guess that, you know, that's a sign that there was something not on the up and up that happened.
Yeah, man.
But
then you already saying that they're trying to kill you, shit.
Yeah.
That's
crazy. Yeah, talk about this upcoming performance, man, that you got going, coming up, man. Is it the guy, I've never heard of him before, his name is Berga, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Talk about that, man.
Oh, we got the second annual All-White Boss Affair. You know what I'm saying? My Block Star promotion. It's gonna be me, Natural, and Berga performing. You know what I mean? Berga from Melbourne. He's a rapper from Melbourne. He be snapping.
Yeah. Have you got on the track with him before?
Nah.
No. So it's All White Affair on the Coliseum. Blockstar promotions, right?
Yeah, All White Boss Affair.
Yeah, man, have you guys been sober ever since that tour you guys had last year or something? Have you guys been sober?
I guess.
Nah,
no sober tour coming up soon, though. No sober tour coming up real soon, boy.
You guys haven't been sober since, man. Every time I go on social media, I see you guys doing something, man. Man. The turn up must be, I guess, in that time, must be like crazy. You know what I'm saying? It might be, the turn up must be just crazy, bro.
You just have fun, bro. You just enjoy yourself. You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
No bullshit. Just straight enjoying yourself.
I feel you, man. Hey, man, talk about the future, man. Give some shout outs and, you know what I'm saying, plug anything that you want, man. I know you, this is Saturday, you probably got family time, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead, man.
Shit. Oh, hold on. Hello?
Yeah.
Shit, I just want to shout out the team. One Trey, Block Star Promotion, the team, sure. Really real.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? The whole sure. Never City. You feel me? You gotta be
quiet.
You
want to
come up?
Yeah, man. When can we realistically expect Bipolar off safety? You there? Hello? Sounds like we might have left. Gotti might have just either, phone died or something, man. But anyways, man, it was a great interview, man. Young Gotti, man. Make sure you guys go check him out on Facebook, man. Bipolar Off Safety. Man, this is No Cupcake Zone. You feel me? Anyways, man, make sure to go check out my website, NoCupcakeZone.com. Also, Spreaker. That's SpreaKer.com. And look up No Cupcake Zone Podcast. Also, check me up on iTunes. Look up No Cupcake Zone. Get all my podcasts and subscribe. And when you see it on Facebook, make sure you share the podcast, man. Feel me, man. But I think we lost Young Gotti. But anyways, man, you guys tune in next week, man. I got another show coming. You feel me? Yeah.
Make sure to tune in next week for our all-new episode of the No Cupcake Zone podcast. Don't forget to go to NoCupcakeZone.com to subscribe to this podcast.
Nigga, what's that bullshit? Hey, shout out that high six. Don't leave the crib without a Glock grill. Watching cameras in the trap. I ain't on no block, bitch. Y'all mind chill with 100. Hollin' out, nigga, fuck it. Five of my homeboys just got murdered in 3 months, bitch. Hey, little shit, dead for real. Ain't wrong slick, you dead for real. Killers up in fire, bet believe, bruh. They shoot the kill. Won't ever catch me naked. Stay with protection. Got my felony drop. So far, I'm a possession. You know I'm flexing. When I leave, she messy. I don't even give a fuck. Hey, blow the boy, don't test. But I'm in my own lane. I ain't worried about the next nigga. Folks on my own chain. Look, money is the issue. Stunt jab boys gon' fix ya. I'm telling y'all, ain't that real. Ain't flying dope, they gon' hit ya. Ain't Florida boy, don't bend ya. On both ends of that pistol. So fuck a bitch can't tell me nothing. Fuck the fuck, nigga. Drippin' on my chopper. Twistin' blunts up real proper. Chopper on my lap, eatin' steak, shrimp, and pasta. No squad, nigga, no partners. Big licks, I'll rob ya. Keep my pistol on my hip, my nigga, yeah, I got it.
Clutching on that bitch, I'm 75. I got my ain't high with my 200 rounds with my. He ain't never me to whack ass out. I got my chopper, got bipolar out safety. Slide around with that Mac 90. Fuck nigga, don't make me. And them cop killers gon' fucking find you. I ain't playing around with you pussy niggas. You pussy niggas be the one to kill me. So on sight, I'm running down. Spit 100 rounds to get one movie. Monkey on the stick, bitch. Scrapped up,
nigga like Boosie. This one Trey shit real talk. Better ask a bit how the boys do ya. I rock and roll, but I love the blues. Nigga gotta figure out the clues to you. I don't run, I move to you. Got your family singing sad tunes to you. You fucked up and I'm fucked up, but you fucked up when you fuck with me. Bitch, I make that chopper dance like Frank Sinatra. Music theme, yellow tape, crime scene. Now everybody looking for the iron team, but between me and these 100 rounds ain't shit.